Hello and happy day. Have you reminded yourself to slow down today, to reduce the noise, to listen? My name is Igor, SF Walker, and I'm here to remind people to slow down, to reduce the noise, to walk their lives into a natural flow. Welcome back to the Book of the Week series. Every week, as I read another amazing title, I share it with the world. And today, we look at how children succeed. Grit, Curiosity, and the Hidden Power of Character by Paul Tough. Tools of the Mind approach doesn't focus much on reading and math abilities. Instead, all of its interventions are intended to help children learn a different kind of skill: controlling their impulses, staying focused on the task at hand, avoiding distractions and mental traps, managing their emotions, and organizing their thoughts. Tools of the Mind students are taught a variety of strategies and tricks, as well as habits that they can deploy to keep their mind on track. Strength of character, which included being conscientious, responsible, insistently orderly, not prone to daydreaming, determined, preserving, when used as a measure, was three times more successful in determining and predicting college performance than any combination of cognitive ratings, including SAT scores and class rank. Two of the most important executive functions are cognitive flexibility and cognitive self-control. Cognitive flexibility is the ability to see alternative solutions to problems, to think outside of the box, to negotiate unfamiliar situations. Cognitive self-control is the ability to inhibit an instinctive or a habitual response and substitute a more effective, less obvious one. Among the 34 member countries of the Organization for the Economic Cooperation and Development, or OECD, the United States still ranks a respectable 8 in its college enrollment rate. But in the college completion, the percentage of entering college freshmen who actually go on to graduate, the United States ranks 2nd to last, ahead of only Italy. Not long ago, the United States led the world in producing college graduates. Now, it leads the world in producing college dropouts. What happened? Here's what Paul says about his boy. As Ellington grew older, I found, as countless parents had found before me, that he needed something more than just love and hugs. He also needed discipline. He needed rules and limits, someone to say no. And what he needed more than anything was some child-sized adversity, a chance to fall down and get back up on his own without any help. If we really want our children to succeed, we need to first let them fail. Or more precisely, we need to help them learn to manage failure. We need to let ourselves fail and discover ways to learn from these failures, which will lead us to fear failure less. If you have enjoyed this video, please do like it, share it with the world, subscribe to my channel, and you can find a direct link to this book in the description below. Get it and read. Thank you. Love and respect.